The Great Ocean Road is one of the most iconic stretches of road in Australia. Winding its way along 243 kilometres of rugged coastline, it connects townships that were once only accessible by boat or by an arduous journey through hard country. Built in part by returned servicemen, the road is a living memorial to the Victorians who served in World War I and the longest war memorial in the world. 2019 marks 100 years since construction began.
I think it's important that we put a human face to this project called the Great Ocean Road Project. We need to think about the people that built that road and what they went through. People need to understand when they drive the ocean road that there is a real human story to it.
Lorne is located 139 kilometres west of Melbourne. The people of Eastern Mar have lived in this land for more than 40,000 years.
We have several language groups, so we're filming in Lorne today, and this is Gadigal country. To the north of us is Gulijing. To the west of Gulijing is Jagatrun, then there's Karabarun, and further west is Dalwatrun, but it ends in Karay country, the Great Ocean Road.
The Great Ocean Road project employed over 2,000 returned soldiers and made the once isolated coastal communities accessible by road.
Now the idea was to open up the Otway coast for all weather access, because prior to that, if it was rough weather in the sea and little schooners and things couldn't get into the piers to supply the town, nor could they go over the range where it was all muddy and boggy with the horses and coaches, they were stuck here.
Doug Stirling has lived in Lorne since 1922. The road to the town was officially opened in March of that year.
When the Great Ocean Road was built, it meant that they had this all-weather access, whatever happened, and they could get to Melbourne from Lorne in 3 hours, and we could get the daily paper here for breakfast. So these were big achievements.
In the early days, to drive the road, you had to pay tolls. Doug spent his summers playing on the beach with the toll gatekeeper's kids. When their mum was working the gate, toll dodgers were not tolerated.
I knew all the kids and I used to play with them. And every now and then one would nip up and tell mum that there's somebody walking along the beach in a suit carrying a suitcase. Well, mum would leave the gate locked and she'd race down and head them off. And she had a good handle on language, I can tell you. And she told them in good colloquial Australian what she thought of them, because she said that they were dodging a shilling toll, doing the diggers out of a bob, as she called it, and this meant that it was unpatriotic. Well, Lorne was a village when I was a boy. It had an industry around the place, sawmilling, timber cutting generally, and also fishing. It functioned as a village because it had all the tradesmen, it had all the service people like the Country Roads Board for the roads and telecom and all those type of thing, and lots of families, big families, whereas later on it became a tourist town.
Lorne-based surf and pop culture historian Murray Walding has spent a lifetime documenting life on the coast.
I started to realise that when you look at surfing in terms of the action in the water, it's not particularly revealing apart from the way surfing styles change. But if you look at the action in the car parks and on the beach, you see the different cars, you see the different fashions, you get an idea of what music people were listening to. I think you get a broader view of Australia's own beach culture. It's a unique beach culture. It's not like other countries' beach culture.
Well, I've been living in Lorne since halfway through 1960, and I haven't gone and lived anywhere else because it's too pretty.
In 1964, Gail Cooper became the first female surfer to win an event at Bells Beach. Over the next decade, she won a record 9 times. Now, more than 50 years on, Cooper still holds the record for the most Bells Beach trophies.
And then we moved to Lorne.
Just the sheer enjoyment of being in the water. Every day the weather was different and the surf was different, and competing was a very tiny part of it, really. More it was about being on a surfboard in the ocean and travel, which I love doing.
With 10 waterfalls within 10 kilometres, pristine beaches and the natural beauty of the Otways, Lorne has been attracting holidaymakers for over a century. Take in some history at the Lawn Theatre, built in 1937 and still showing films today. The relaxed atmosphere, foodie scene and the buzzing arts community means there's something to see and do all year round. To hear more stories of the Great Ocean Road, continue west to Wye River and Apollo Bay, or east to Anglesey and Torquay.